FBI under siege top brass. Agents slammed as Bureau fights to overcome scandals and blunders from the storied hallways of the J. Edgar Hoover building to field offices around the country. The Federal Bureau of Investigation faces a crisis of confidence as rank-and-file agents are blamed for not preventing recent attacks and top brass finds itself in the middle of an unfolding political fight. The blitz of bad news is taking a toll on the intensely proud Bureau's members, both past and present. In my experience, I can't say I know of any parallel to what is going on now, former FBI Assistant Director Ron Hosko told Fox News. A two-pronged attack on the Bureau's credibility reached a crescendo last week, when the Bureau admitted it had not acted on a tip that might have stopped Florida school shooter Nicholas Cruz. President Trump, in turn, seized on the grave error to effectively accuse the Bureau of making mistakes because agents have been consumed with a Russia probe, while the Dutch triumphantly announced Friday that Special Counsel Robert Mueller's investigation had indicted 13 Russian nationals. Trump stressed that the case did not show collusion with his campaign. The ignored warning about Cruz was especially painful, because it was the second such admission in the case. Cruz gunned down 17 students at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida, on February 14. It quickly emerged that a YouTuber had warned the FBI someone sharing the same name had said he wanted to be a professional school shooter back in September. Then came word on Friday that another tipster had given the Bureau an even more specific warning January 5, and that had also been ignored. This kid was flashing red and the system failed, Hosko said. The FBI has had its piece in that, and it's a significant piece. Trump was quick to tie the two issues together, tweeting that the Bureau missed signals because it was spending too much time trying to prove Russian collusion with the Trump campaign, then urging it to get back to the basics and make us all proud. FBI Director Christopher Wray, selected by Trump to bring stability to the Bureau after he fired James Comey, has vowed to get to the bottom of what happened in this particular matter. But Florida Gov. Rick Scott has had enough. In his view, Wray, who was just installed as the Bureau's new leader on September 28, already has to go. An apology will never bring these 17 Floridians back to life or comfort the families who are in pain, Scott said last week. The families will spend a lifetime wondering how this could happen, and an apology will never give them the answers they desperately need.